Have you ever made the situation you have put a long cable from the PoE NVR to the PoE camera? After you set up everything, there's just no video from the camera. Even the camera is getting the power. In this video, I'm going to show you the typical solution to work on a long run PoE by using this PoE standard. There are multiple ways to deal with the long run PoE. I've worked out a complete guide, which including how to pick the PoE standard, how to connect the system, and what is the possible issue you may face. What you need to do, just follow the link in the description below to download the free guide. First thing first, why long run PoE doesn't work? The reason is because the TCP/IP protocol is limited to about 328 feet over the Cat5 Cat6 Ethernet cable. If the distance between the camera and the PoE NVR is beyond 328 feet, the signal will start dropping. The simple solution is we can add this PoE standard before 328 feet. One PoE standard can repeat another 328 feet, so totally we got 1650 feet after we add one PoE standard. But there's one concern by using this solution. You see, we need to put this PoE standard at the middle of the cable. If the cable is being pulling in the conduct, then you realize the distance is too long, then it will be very difficult to add this PoE standard at the middle of the cable. This is one thing. The second thing is it will increase the failure point. Let's say if you need to bury the cable under the ground, which means you also need to bury this PoE standard under the ground. So it increases the failure point. Now, I'm going to introduce the second solution. We can use the continue run. There's no need to put the PoE standard at the middle of the cable. Then we just need to put the PoE standard at both ends. Okay, now let's move to the demonstration board and see how we can put two PoE standard to set up the continue run for long run PoE. This is 1000 feet continue run Cat5 Ethernet cable. If I connect one end to the PoE NVR and connect another end to the camera directory, it's not going to work. The TCP/IP network is limited to about 328 feet. The typical solution is we can use two PoE standard, just put the first one before 328 feet and put the second one before 650 feet. Eventually, we got the 1000 feet running, but we need to place this PoE standard at the middle of the cable, which we don't want to do. So in this setup, I'm going to place these two PoE standard both ends, or we can use the continue run Cat5 Ethernet cable. First, let me connect the PoE standard to the PoE NVR. I also need this short punch code. The tricky thing is we need to link the output port. We need to flick the first PoE standard, connect the output port to the PoE NVR. Then we connect the cable from the camera. Now let's move to the camera and set up the second PoE standard. Here we connect the input port to the cable from the PoE NVR. Then use the short punch code to link the output port to the camera. So eventually, we are using the continue run Ethernet cable. I can hear the cameras moving now. It will take a while before we can see the live video on the monitor. Let's just wait for a while. Now the camera's live. It's the motorized zoom camera. It will take a while before we can see the best focus on the monitor. The one thing you really need to know is PoE standard never repeat the power. It just repeat the data. We send the power over the Cat5 Cat6 Ethernet cable. Part of the power will convert to the heat and get lost. It introduces the power loss. The longer the cable, the more power loss will be. So when we deal with the long run PoE network, you may need to consider the power loss, even if you have take care of the data. If the power is not enough, then we can use the new PoE standard PoE-BT, aka PoE++, to inject higher power to the Cat5 Cat6 Ethernet cable. Eventually, you have enough power for the IP camera. This is the 90W PoE injector. You can inject 90W power to the Cat5 Cat6 Ethernet cable. You also can reference my another video, how to use the 90W PoE injector to increase the power in the long run PoE network.